Hi everyone! Hello Lula
Hello.
community! Welcome to our first Facebook live chat.
Yep.
This is
things.
This is exciting for us, and I'm really excited to engage with you guys. Let's start off with some introductions.
Yep.
This is Wanga. He's amazing. But aside from that, tell me what you do here at Lula. What's your story?
Yeah, so I'm heading up the sales department. Where we deal day in, day out with SME owners, you know, get to relate and hear all these fantastic stories of, you know, where they come from and where they are at right now. And, you know, also just relating in terms of how we can actually assist them and how we've been assisting SMEs. I'm obviously heading up the sales department, and that's pretty much it on my side.
He's playing it down. He's like a total business funding whiz kid. And so he's got lots of pearls of wisdom to share with you guys today. And I'm Carly. I'm part of the marketing team here at Lula, and I'm the customer relationship kind of specialist, marketer, goddess, empress, whatever you want to call it. I'm essentially tasked with building community and taking you guys on a journey, and this is very much a part of it because I think it's a two-way conversation, right?
Yes.
We really appreciate hearing what you guys think. We really want to be there for you, your friend in funding, to help you understand how our process works and what we do. So we're waiting for you guys to join. And by the way, if you have any questions, all you need to do is just comment and
yep.
we'll answer the question that you've got.
Hi, Ross. We see you there. We see you.
Hello, Ross. Welcome to say hi to us. And we'll try and address everything we've got. We'll also post this discussion. This video will be on our Facebook feed for any time when you want to go and watch it. And we'll be able to kind of post some more resources in there for you, like
yeah.
our blogs and stuff that we think might be helpful based on the stuff you ask us. So now that the housekeeping's out the way, because people have lives and businesses to run.
Yep, money to make.
I'm going to just kind of kick things off and I think talk a bit about Lula and who we are and what it is that we do. So Lula Lend is essentially an online platform where small businesses and medium businesses can apply for funding for their business.
Mm-hmm.
So anything up to 1.5 million rand. And it's all really slick and really quick and really easy, which, I mean, I don't own my own business, but I have to tell you, I recently went to the bank to kind of do some admin because I've just moved to Cape Town. We're based in Cape Town. That's something you should know. But we have, you know, customers and clients all over South Africa, all over South Africa. Anyway, I had to fika and I had to do like all this admin and paperwork at the bank. And that's not even me applying for funding.
Yeah.
That's like me just trying to manage my life.
Yeah.
So I think that's really the most awesome thing about what we do here is that
yeah.
it's slick, it's online and it's easy and it's paperless. Like
exactly.
Who needs paper?
Business owners need something on the roll all the time. You know, you don't want to be standing in business queues, you know, speaking to 500 different people, different departments before you actually get an outcome. And with Lula Lend, the game changer, literally within 24 to 48 hours, you know exactly where you stand. You're able to work accordingly and plan accordingly based on the quote that we issue to you.
Yeah, so I mean, that's us in a nutshell. But I think, you know, I've had a lot of people ask like, well, how's this different? Like what makes you different to say getting a traditional loan? And I think it's quite important to talk about that. So we're a short-term funder, right?
Yeah.
We're different from a bank. So how are we different? Maybe you can chat about that.
Well, there's quite a lot of things, Carly. I mean, firstly, it's just also from the relationship point of view. You know, we have that thing with our clients where, you know what, it's literally like a family, friends in funding that we have relationship with them. Also, the process, like you've obviously explained, it's much more faster, much more easier. No paperwork required, no nitty-gritties. We've got online algorithms that can pick up all the verifications we need to do. And literally, the process is so slick and easy. You don't have to stress about anything. If you want to speak to someone and you don't want to do it yourself online, you're more than welcome to. We've got business funding specialists ready on the go to give you a call, take you through the whole process, and do it on your behalf. You don't have to lift
that's
the finger.
That's pretty cool.
Yep.
I like not having to lift a finger. Like, give me the least possible amount of work to do.
Yeah.
And, okay, so I'm a business owner. I've come to your website, to our website, and I'm like, okay, cool. I want to apply for funding. Can anyone apply for funding? Are there some, you know, restrictions to that? I would say largely everyone can apply for funding, but there are a couple of minimum requirements. What are those?
So basically, our main target market in terms of SMEs would definitely be businesses with trading for 12 months or longer. They must have a monthly turnover of 40,000 Rand, and annually that needs to accumulate to around 500,000, all right? In terms of specific industries and sector, we cater for quite a lot, and literally anywhere in the country, regardless of where you are, you're more than welcome to apply. Tom, you see your question there.
Yes, so I think this is a good question, and we'll just jump in and answer them as we go. What is the main reason for funding that customers apply for? Now, there's quite a range of reasons why people would apply for funding. Mm-hmm. It can be anything from, you know, paying salaries, or you need to like purchase more stock because it's December and hello, people are buying Christmas presents and we need to do all the things and have all the things ready for them. But if we look at our community and what our community actually does, 33% of our community applies for funding because they need to purchase more equipment, which I think is interesting.
Yes.
So guys that are maybe in like what, your construction, manufacturing industries,
automobile industry.
Yeah.
You know, you always want to stay current with what's happening and have the latest equipment to ensure that you're servicing your clients to the best of your ability.
Yeah, and upgrading your old equipment to new equipment. So equipment is actually our number one reason for funding that most people have. The second most popular is actually inventory. So I mean, on a similar vein, stock. Exactly what I've just said. Yeah. So it's Black Friday, which we've just had, a crazy Black Friday, and you want to make sure that you've got the goods to deliver for the customer demand that you're going to have. Sometimes that's seasonal, sometimes it's a Black Friday thing, sometimes you just, there's just a lot of demand for a certain product. So that's the second thing. And the third thing is just bridging finance. So I mean, maybe you've got some good examples of what that looks like.
Yeah, so I mean, a lot of the clients that we come across on a daily might literally need financing just to, you know, take them over this rough path that they're quickly going through, and they're awaiting a payment that's going to land in a couple of months or so. And that's exactly what bridging finance can do. You know, they can literally use our capital to sustain their overheads at the end of the month and literally maintain the business and its cash flow. And I mean, the funds we provide effectively are unrestricted. So what you do with the money in the business is entirely up to you. You know, and also just on the stock point, a lot of the guys also enjoy purchasing their stock using actual cash capital rather than on a 30-day account with creditors, because they end up paying, you know, ridiculous markups on that. Mm. Whereas with us, we give you the capital, you purchase your stock, you're able to settle us early, and literally you save up on those costs, you know, and literally depending on how long you can turn your stock over, literally that's where the main benefit would lie.
I think that's also something that we should mention, which I think is really interesting, because I actually didn't know that traditionally when you take out funding or you take a loan out and you pay it back early, you actually get penalties on that.
That is true.
That's the way that it's always been done traditionally. Yep. Sucks. So we don't do that. We actually don't penalize you for paying off, you know, the funding that you receive from us early, which means you can actually save a lot of money on costs.
Quite a lot. So you actually pay for the money for as long as you keep it.
Yeah.
Literally.
So if I'm a guy and I'm like, well, I'm not a guy, I'm a girl. If I'm a business owner and I say, look, I know that the supply is going to pay me in a month's time, but I need to actually pay my costs this
right
month
now,
and I don't have that money right now, I'm going to just take funding to cover me for this 1 month until that supply pays me. And then you'll ultimately pay that funding back in the first month, which means you'll, I mean, if you on average, we're looking at a funding of say 100,000 Rand based on like our risk, our average risk. And you pay that off in the first month, I mean, you'd only be paying what, like?
Look, I mean, on a six-month plan, 100K, you're probably looking at about 17K. So based on 1 month, it would be ridiculously low, literally.
Yeah.
And that would inevitably increase your margins in terms of what profits you're making, because you're literally keeping the money just for a month. And that's exactly what you're going to be charged for, just that exact
I think
month.
That's pretty cool. I like that ability to be flexible.
Yes.
Yeah, that'll be awesome. So we're talking about money, and money matters to business owners. I think it matters to everyone.
Yeah,
so let's talk about money. Let's talk about how, that's actually one of the most common questions we get, is how does your cost structure work? What do you guys charge? What is your interest rate? So I'm gonna let you actually answer that question, because you probably answer that question every day.
Yeah, no, definitely. I mean, look, the first thing I always tell our clients, like we said, our approach is literally a personal approach. And we understand that businesses operate differently. There's different costs involved for different businesses. And because of that, we've got different pricing brackets, all right? So we literally work with a markup, which is different from business to business. On average, like we said, if you're looking at about 100K, your markup is 17,000 over 6 months, all right? And that's literally more like a worst case scenario.
Yeah, yeah, that's based on like average risk, yeah, figures, but we assess you very personally based on the business's, you know,
credit worthiness, the industry type, and a few other factors that we obviously look into. Also, you're looking at a breakdown in terms of the costing structure, it's between 2 and 6%, which effectively on the first 2 months we would then take a higher portion, and then the remaining term, if you're looking at a 6 month plan on a form, the remaining 4 months would obviously then be just a flat 2% of the cost of the capital.
Right, and what I think is really cool, I mean, I've chatted to a couple of business owners in our community, and one thing they've really said to me is, it's just nice to have those costs be really transparent, because as a business owner, you're trying to plan, yeah, like your next 5 minutes and your next 5 years.
Exactly.
Right?
And just on that, the benefit of that mainly is the fact that it's fixed. One thing I forgot to mention. So you're not looking to get any surprises throughout your plan. Whereas with the traditional lenders, you know, they've got APRs which fluctuate and, you know, which are controlled by macroeconomic issues.
Sounds really complicated. I have no idea what you're
talking about. Well, that's exactly the thing. With the bank, they would literally do that, you know, where throughout your term, they tell you now, look, things are going up. Your interest rate is also going up. With us, yeah, it's fixed. You know exactly what you're getting yourself into. It's transparent, no hidden fees whatsoever.
And I think it's important to say, like, we're not really competing with banks.
No, definitely.
Like we're offering something completely different.
It's a different product on its own.
Short term funding for business owners straight up, and it's quite specific. So we're in no ways trying to compete with the bank. They can do what they're doing. And then yeah, I think another question that I actually was sent, we asked you guys to comment with some questions. One of the questions just around our costing, like, some people will say, I've applied for a quote, I've applied for funding of up to, say, R1 million, mm-hmm, but I've only been quoted for R500,000. Why is there a difference? If I've applied for R1 million, why am I only getting 500,000?
Yeah, that's a very good question. So mainly the reason around that would be around affordability, all right? So because our product literally is an unsecured funding product, which means we don't actually require any assets or security towards the actual loan, we then obviously look at affordability and the business's performance historically. All right, so we request 3 months bank statements in order to start off the process. And based off that, we're then able to derive more or less what the affordability of the business is. And that's mainly based on the average bank balance of the business throughout the month. So a lot of the clients will then, after, you know, engaging in that conversation, understand exactly why they got less than what they actually requested. And at the end, yeah, of the day, we also don't want to overextend our clients by providing them with funding, which we know might literally put them in a bit of a corner. We literally here to help businesses grow, back businesses that can back themselves, and, you know, not overextend them in terms of capacity.
Yeah, we sort of have a mantra here about being responsible lenders, because we are super passionate about small businesses in South Africa, and we really want to empower those businesses. We don't want to cripple them with debt. Yeah. So we would never put you in a position where you are taking on way too much funding. Those quotes are based on, like, intense analysis, a lot of people applying their minds, amazing little crazy algorithms doing all the maths to make sure that you're not in that position. Mm. And so that's why sometimes there's a discrepancy. Guys, as I said, as you ask questions, we'll answer them. But if not, I'm just going to keep rambling on for a little bit longer about some of the questions that our community often asks us. And so I hope that addresses everything. But if there's something more you want to know, please feel free to comment and we'll try and address it. So one of the other questions I sometimes come across is, like, people are going, Lula Lane sounds like way too good to be true. Are you guys real? Are you real people? What is happening?
Yeah.
So we're real. This is actually happening. And Lula Lane is a legit business. We've been around for over 4 years. We're part of an industry body called SASFA, which means we also subscribe to a code of conduct. You know, we aim to be give really fair service to all SMEs, and we're in that group together with a bunch of other companies. So we're real and we're legit. I would encourage you, if you're curious to know more about us, to do a simple Google search, and you'll notice that we come up in a lot of industry publications. We've been on radio. There's a lot of articles that have been written about us, and I think that will bolster sort of our reputation as being a responsible, legit lender. You can always look us up on LinkedIn as well. I'm on there, Wang is on there. Come connect with us. You're welcome to do so as well. We are real and we are legit. And we have your best interests in mind.
Yes.
Here we go. You read it, Wang, go for it.
Michael Mercy says, what kind of businesses do you fund and what has been the impact?
Okay, cool. So I get really excited about this stuff because I'm really amazed since I started working here at the range of businesses that we're able to support, the incredible talent that South Africa has, and just these awesome stories. So I kind of went and picked out a couple that I thought would give a good indication as to kind of the range of people that have applied for funding with us already and successfully gotten funding. Mm-hmm. So anything from a 28-year-old tattoo shop owner in Roodepoort to a 50-year-old hardware shop in Sea Point, 50-year-old business owner, not the hardware shop. Maybe it's been around for 50 years. A 47-year-old who runs a transport company in Randfontein, a 30-year-old who runs a sustainable energy business in Benito, and a 35-year-old who runs a coffee shop right here in Cape Town in Gardens. Yeah. I mean, that's just a handful that I picked out of this amazing, amazing community that we have of South African SMEs. And it's really anything from, we've got business owners as young as 20 who are getting funding of up to 350,000 rand to support their IT company. I mean, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So there isn't really any specific person or people.
Wide range.
No, and I think to speak to the impact, I mean, we've spoken about the kinds of reasons why people would want funding. So you can imagine the impact that it has when you're able to supply stock or able to upgrade your equipment and what kind of revenue that generates for you as a business with that ability. But I think maybe you, because you speak to customers all the time, is there any sort of major impact that you found in your discussions?
Yeah, I mean, look, just the other day I was talking to a client of mine in PE who is in the automobile industry, and he literally was able to purchase equipment using our funding, which allows him to diagnose cars on another level. You know, it's new equipment.
So,
Diagnostics? Yes. So literally, I mean, the equipment's been around for a couple of months, and he's now currently the only guy in his area which has that equipment, which obviously now means that he's in demand. Improvements, you know, he's now looking to get bigger premises to obviously accommodate all the cars that are now coming into his automobile. So it's things like that, you know. The true value literally of the product is how you leverage off it to make it grow your business. And obviously, you know, because it's also unrestricted, you know exactly where to put the money, you know exactly where to fit it.
Yeah, I mean, some of the other reasons people get funding is to do marketing or to pay bills or to do renovations, or, you know, we don't really have a say in what you do with it. We're just there to support you through whatever you need it for. So I think we're going to use that as a good closing point.
Yes.
If there's no other questions, also at any time, if you are going to watch this later on when you've got a bit more time to focus and you want to ask questions later, it will be on our Facebook timeline and you can simply comment and we'll respond with the relevant answer or a blog or anything that we think can really help you. Guys, if you enjoyed this chat, I would really recommend you go check out our YouTube channel and you go and look at some of our customer stories on our website. There's some really inspirational stories and we're adding to them all the time. If you're a customer of ours and you want to share your story, also reach out to us. We'd love to hear you. It's really cool to just chat face to face with you, and we're going to do this a whole lot more.
Yeah,
so
definitely.
Yeah, join us next time.
Thank you for joining.
Thank you.
Cheers, guys.
Bye.